My name's Matt. This is a nice little area to let the water slow down before it goes into Ada Hayden. Well, it's muddy because the water's been up here before. We still get kind of some movement even up through the soil profile for some water. So it's just kind of muddy on the edge of the little pond or wetland here. Oh, probably the type of light that we have in there, maybe the depth. If it's very shallow water, it's more likely to have wetland features where we have some submerged vegetation, very slow water. A pond in some cases may just be very, very stagnant water, not water moving through there, and could be a lot deeper as well. Probably not rabbits, but probably frogs. Insects, we can see a dragonfly kind of flying over the top of it. Maybe even some, at times, depending on the depth, some minnows or something like that. So more aquatic-like than mammals. Wetlands are important because they help slow down the water. And also, we get natural processes to remove stuff that we don't want in our water. If we have things like nitrogen, that soil that's on the bottom of the wetland can help remove that nitrogen via the denitrification process. Doesn't that sound cool? Denitrification, we convert that nitrate into a nitrogen gas, and so we're emitting gas off the top of the wetland. And a lot of our atmosphere is nitrogen, so that's okay. I probably wouldn't want to swim in wetlands. They're not going to be very deep. And the water might not be quite as, at least a lot of our wetlands, we probably don't want to swim in because they might have a fair bit of nutrients and also maybe at times some bacteria. So we want to just watch the signs that are out there and swim where it's okay to swim. Do you like to chase frogs?
No.
Do you like to chase voles? Yeah. You like voles?
That's great.